Hello, my dear friends. Hope you all are fine. Hope you know me. But still, who are new to this channel, I would like to give my introduction. Myself, Dr. Megha Soni. I am a physiotherapist and I have done my master in neurology. Now, I am going to take very important topic. Lot of confusion among the student about this topic, that is UMN and LMN lesion. So today I will try to make it clear. Hope you have seen my previous lecture, that is corticospinal tract, because the UMN lesion is totally based on the corticospinal tract. So first I would like to give you the basic idea about the UMN, what is UMN, upper motor neuron and LMN, and then I will give the difference between UMN and LMN type of lesion. Okay? If you have not seen my previous lecture, I'll provide a link. You can just go through that link and see my that lecture. So now we'll start with the UMN, the basic idea about upper motor neuron and the lower motor neuron. So what is upper motor neuron? We have seen corticospinal tract. Okay, so these are the neuron of this tract which gives the origin of the axon of corticospinal tract. It decussate at the level of medulla oblongata and it will go to the opposite side of alpha motor neuron. It synapses with the alpha motor neuron. Okay, so this portion is called as mainly upper motor neuron type of portion region. Other than corticospinal tract, there are other descending tracts like rubrospinal tract, vestibulospinal tract, tectospinal tract. Okay, they are also considered as a upper motor neuron because the neuron of this tract are situated within the brainstem and it ends at the level of spinal cord. But mainly, corticospinal tract plays an important role in a upper motor neuron type of lesion. Now, if you have seen that this corticospinal tract is synapses with the alpha motor neuron. This is the alpha motor neuron. And this alpha motor neuron supplies the skeletal muscle of our peripheral body. So now we'll see the local structure of a spinal cord. Okay, this defines mainly the LMN type of lesion. So this is the cross-sectional of spinal cord. The nerve which originated from the alpha motor neuron will supply the skeletal muscle. So this is the efferent nerve and this is the nerve ending, that is the presynaptic region, and this is the postsynaptic. So it forms a neuromuscular junction. All of you know neuromuscular junction, that is the chemical synapse. Okay, so first we'll see the basic physiology of this. This is the structure of muscle. And muscle are made up of extrafusal muscle fiber and the intrafusal muscle fiber. So this is the extrafusal muscle fiber and this black portion is intrafusal muscle fiber. Now this intrafusal muscle fiber is also called as a muscle spindle. This is muscle spindle. This muscle spindle is also called as a stretchoreceptor. Okay? Because extrafusal muscle fiber cannot contract by itself. Okay, extrafusal muscle fiber cannot contract by itself. There is a direct connection between the intrafusal muscle fiber and the extrafusal muscle fiber. Due to intrafusal muscle fiber, the extrafusal muscle fiber can stretch or a contract. So we'll see that. Okay, this is the intrafusal muscle fiber. Now the intrafusal muscle fiber has a sensory supply. Okay, this is the sensory supply. It is going to the posterior part of the spinal cord. It synapses with the interneuron. Okay, and then it again synapses with the alpha motor neuron. So this is the total stretch reflex arc. Okay, whenever you apply a slight stretch, the intramuscular muscle fiber is surrounded by the nuclear chain and nuclear back fiber, sensory fiber. So whenever you give slight stretch, the sensation will be traveled from the posterior part of the spinal cord. Okay, then it synapses with the alpha motor neuron. So the alpha motor neuron gives origin to the motor nerve. So this sensation will be go at the level of the extrafusal muscle fiber and it will stretch that muscle. Okay, clear with this? By this way the muscle stretches. Now there is another one concept, that this is the efferent nerve fiber of the intrafusal muscle fiber. Now the motor nerve fiber of the intrafusal muscle fiber, which is connected with the gamma motor neuron, as you know, there are two type of neuron, gamma motor neuron and the alpha motor neuron. So this intrafusal muscle fiber has two supplies, sensory and the motor. Sensory will go to the posterior part of this spinal cord. It will synapse with the alpha motor neuron as well as the gamma motor neuron. The motor nerve of gamma motor neuron will supply the intrafusal muscle fiber, and the motor nerve of alpha motor fiber will supply the end portion of the extrafusal muscle fiber. So whenever you apply the stretch, the sensation will go to the spinal cord. The action potential will travel from the posterior part of the spinal cord and through the motor nerve, which is arising from the gamma motor neuron, the action potential will reach at the level of muscle spindle, that is the intrafusal muscle fiber, and it contracts the intrafusal muscle fiber. Now this intrafusal muscle fiber is a miniature, so it cannot produce a sufficient amount of contraction. So what will happen, this motor fiber will stimulate this intrafusal muscle fiber further, so more amount of action potential again will travel to the posterior part of the spinal cord, and now because the action potential are more in amount, now it will travel through the alpha motor neuron or a nerve which arising from the alpha motor neuron, and this nerve just gives the innervate the extrafusal muscle fiber, and this extrafusal muscle fiber will be stretched and the contraction takes place. So this is all about the local level of the physiology of neuron and the axon and nerve fiber. So now what is lower motor neuron? So lower motor neuron means the cell bodies. All of you know the anterior gray horn cell consists of mainly two cell body, that is alpha motor neuron and gamma motor neuron. So the cell body and the nerve, the spinal nerve which are arising from the cell body are called as lower motor neuron. Again, the cell body from which the nerves arise, that is called as a lower motor neuron type of lesion. So simply, you can see in this diagram that this upper motor neuron is synapse with the lower motor neuron. Okay? It means the upper motor neuron controls the lower motor neuron because it synapses with the lower motor neuron. So up to this portion is totally called as UMN type of lesion. And from alpha motor neuron to the skeletal muscle, this portion is called as totally lower motor neuron type of region. Now, as I said, that the lower motor neuron means the soma or a cell body from which the nerve arises. All of you know in our body mainly there are two types of nerve, cranial nerves and the spinal nerve. We have seen the spinal nerves, right? But cranial nerves are situated in brainstem. This is the structure of brainstem. This is midbrain, this is pons, medulla oblongata, and this is thalamus. So the cranial nerves are also arising from that nuclei, cell body, and then cell body are situated in midbrain, pons and medulla oblongata. So though this cranial nerve and nuclei are situated in brainstem, it is situated above the spinal cord, still this structure are called as a lower motor neuron, because the definition of lower motor neuron is very simple. Any nerve which arises from the cell body or a nuclei, that portion is called as a lower motor neuron. Okay, in our body, two types of nerves, spinal nerves, 31 pairs of spinal nerve and the 12 pairs of cranial nerve, and that nerves are having their own cell body or a nuclei. Okay, so this any damage to this structure can cause lower motor neuron type of lesion. Again, though this is situated in brainstem above the level of spinal cord, it is considered, any damage to this pathway can consider as lower motor neuron lesion. I hope you all are clear with this idea. Now we'll see the injury, level of injury. What is the function of upper motor neuron over the lower motor neuron? So mainly all the descending tract, corticospinal tract, rubrospinal tract, vestibulospinal tract, these all descending tracts are synapse with the alpha motor neuron, with the interneuron. And this all tract gives inhibitory signal to this alpha motor neuron. This all tract gives inhibitory signal to the alpha motor neuron. Suppose you find a damage of this tract over here. Okay, if you see the damage of this axon at this level. So what will happen? Now this tract cannot pass the inhibitory signal to the alpha motor neuron. Okay, so constantly more amount of axon will pass to the muscle, constant bombarding will be there. So what you will find? Increase in the muscle tone. Because now the upper region, upper motor neuron are not sufficient enough to control the lower motor neuron region. That is why you will find increase in tone in case of UMN type of lesion. Second, UMN type of lesion does not mean that the structure above the spinal cord. It is totally related to the corticospinal tract. So damage to cerebral cortex, midbrain, pons, medulla can directly damage the corticospinal tract, and corticospinal tract damage will give you the UMN type of the symptom. Now we'll see in the LMN type of symptom. Okay, LMN type of symptom, you can see the course of this is the nuclei and the nerve arising from the nuclei, and this is the neuromuscular junction. So any damage between the course of these nuclei, damage to root, damage to rami, damage to cord, damage to branches, okay, up to the neuromuscular junction. So any damage within this course will lead to the element type of lesion. Suppose the damage is here. The damage is here. So the sensation, the sensory signal will be passed at the level of spinal cord, but it will not pass from the alpha, this region, to the this region. And this region, why? Because the damage is here and it will cause the degeneration, Wallerian degeneration. You will find the Wallerian degeneration over here. Okay, signal action potential cannot pass from this damaged area to the muscle. So the muscle will not receive a sufficient amount of this signal to contract. So now muscle cannot contract sufficiently. So you will find the reduction of tone. Okay, so this is the basic difference you may find between UMN and LMN lesion, as the UMN type of structure cannot give inhibitory signal to the lower motor type of lesion. You will find increase in the tone, and in LMN type of lesion, because it is the local structure, in UMN type of lesion this structure is fine, totally fine. Okay, there is no problem in alpha motor neuron or the course of the nerve. Okay, but the problem is from the upper side. Okay. So in this, as it gives the inhibitory signal due to damage to this, it is now not able to pass the inhibitory signal to the alpha motor neuron. You will see increase in the tone, and in element type of lesion, you will not find any problem from the upper side. Now problem is at the local level, at a nerve level. Okay, so it causes Wallerian degeneration. The action potential cannot pass from one end to the another end, and the muscle will not get the sufficient amount of the signal to contract. So in that case you will see the loss of tone. Same like this is the brain stem. You can see this is cranial nerve 2 nuclei, these are the nuclei of cranial nerve 3, these are the nuclei 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11, and these are the nuclei of cranial now 12. So any damage to soma, okay, if there is any damage to soma, it means the nuclei, and any damage to nerve which arising from this nuclei, okay, agar ye cranial nerve 7 hai, yaha pe damage hua, ye yaha pe damage hua, then it will give you all the element type of symptom. Okay, again, this all cranial and nuclei are controlled by the cerebral cortex. So if there is any problem in cerebral cortex, if the cerebral cortex is just, for an example, the cerebral cortex is just managing or controlling the nuclei of cranial nerve 7, and if you find any damage to cerebral cortex, then that lesion will be UMN type of lesion, because there is no damage to nuclei in the nerve. The damage will be from the upper side. Okay, but if you find any due to tumor, this nerve will be compressed. Okay, so at that time there is a problem in the course of the nerve, there is no problem from the upper side, so that this type of lesion will be LMN type of lesion. So again, I would like to revise the definition of UMN. UMN means the nuclei which are situated in cortical and the subcortical region, and which gives the origin to the axon of the descending tract. are called as upper motor neuron, and lower motor neuron means the soma, cell body, and the nerve which arises from that cell body. Okay, any damage to that portion is called as an element type of lesion. So we'll see the difference between UML lesion and element lesion. First is stone. In UML type of lesion, you find hypertonia. Hypertonia means increase in muscle tone. And in element type of lesion, you find hypotonia. Hypotonia means decrease in tone. Why hypertonia? Because the descending tract gives inhibitory signal to the element type of region, and now damage to this tract will not control the element type of region, that is the cell body and the nerves. Okay, so there will be constant stimulation or action potential from alpha motor neuron to the muscle, and it will lead to the increase in the tone or a constant contraction of the muscle tone. And hypotonia due to Wallerian degeneration. Okay, second, due to hypertonia, which type of paralysis you will find in UML type of lesion? Obviously, it is the spastic paralysis. Spasticity means increase in tone. Okay, so in patient with UML type of lesion, you find spastic type of paralysis, and in patient with element type of lesion, you find flaccid type of paralysis. Flaccid type of paralysis means no tone, diminished in tone. Okay, that person is not able to hold the limb against the gravity. If you ask the person to hold the limb against the gravity, that person cannot hold it. Immediately the limb will be dropped down. Clear with this? So this is the mainly two difference of tone and paralysis. Third is atrophy. So in UML type of lesion, you find disuse atrophy. What is disuse atrophy? Due to spastic paralysis, in a chronic stage, the person will not use the muscle for a long period of time. Due to that, there will be loss of muscle girth. That is called as disuse atrophy. This disuse atrophy you find only in a chronic stage of UML lesion, after 6 months or after a year. Okay? And in element type of lesion, you find the atrophy due to denervation. Okay? This is the spinal cord. Alpha motor neuron innervates the muscle as extrafusal, intrafusal muscle fiber. Suppose the damage is here, the action potential cannot travel from this side to this side. So this muscle will not get the sufficient amount of signal to contract. Now this muscle will not contract sufficiently. That is why you will see the flaccid type of paralysis, and that is why the girth of muscle will be reduced slowly. That is called as wasting. So this atrophy is due to the denervation. This is the denervation, and this atrophy in UML type of lesion is due to disuse. It is not because of the denervation. Okay. Now the fourth point is superficial reflex. There are many superficial reflex in our body. Now what is superficial reflex? Superficial reflex is elicited through the mucosal membrane and the skin. Okay. And this superficial reflex, unlike DTR, unlike deep tendon reflex, this superficial reflex is polysynaptic. Means it consists of the sensory pathway, the center, and the motor pathway. There are many superficial reflex like plantar reflex, abdominal reflex, corneal reflex, conjunctival reflex, scapular reflex. So there are many superficial reflex. I would like to give you one example of cornea reflex. Okay, cornea reflex consists of sensory pathway, that is fifth cranial nerve. The center is pons, and the efferent pathway, that is motor pathway, is seventh cranial nerve. So any damage within this can lose this superficial type of reflex. So superficial type of reflex is lost in both type of lesion, UML type of lesion and as well as element type of lesion. Why in UML type of lesion? Because this is polysynaptic pathway. Okay, it consists of the sensory pathway from spinal cord. It goes to the brain, and brain again sends signal back to the spinal cord. So any damage to within this pathway can lead to loss of superficial reflex. And in element type of lesion, okay, in element type of lesion, mostly you find the lesion in motor pathway, efferent nerve. So that is, as the superficial reflex consists of both the pathway, sensory and motor. So damage to this motor pathway will lead to loss of superficial reflex. Now I would like to give the example. I am going to show you this superficial reflex practically. I'm going to give you one example, that is corneal superficial reflex. First, I would like to show you the normal corneal reflex. Make a wisp of cotton. This is the wisp of cotton. And now, from the lateral side of the patient, just insert this wisp of cotton inside the cornea. See the response. What you saw? Immediate blinking of eye, right? So this is the normal reflex. This reflex consists of fifth cranial nerve sensory pathway, the center response, and the efferent pathway is seventh cranial nerve. This blinking is due to the seventh cranial nerve supplies the muscle of it. Okay, now in case of UMN and LMN type of lesion, there will be loss of this reflexes. So when I insert inside the cornea, you will not get the blinking of eye. That we'll see. Okay, this is the patient, assume he is having UMN type of lesion. Now I insert inside the cornea and I am not getting any response. So this is the loss of superficial reflex. So next point is plantar reflex. Okay, plantar reflex is also one of the superficial reflex, but there is a difference in the response of that. In UMN type of lesion, you find Babin skin sign positive, and in LMN type of lesion, there is absent of plantar reflex. Now you have seen this Babin skin response video in my previous lecture. Hope you remember this. If you have not seen it yet, please see it. Okay. So we'll move forward to the another point, that is the deep tendon reflex, which is a monosynaptic reflex. Okay. Now, as I have told you that the corticospinal tract gives inhibitory effect over the stretch reflex. We have seen the stretch reflex, right? The intrafusal muscle fiber and the extrafusal muscle fiber. The intrafusal muscle fiber gives sensory signal to the spinal cord, and it is attached with the gamma motor neuron. Okay, and again it will give sensation through the alpha motor neuron. So this is the stretch reflex. As this, it gives signs the inhibitory signal to the deep tendon reflexes. Any damage to the upper motor neuron region will now not able to give the inhibitory signal to this reflex. So you will find the exaggerated reflex. Okay, due to hypertonia, due to spasticity, you find exaggerated deep tendon reflex. And in LMN type of lesion, due to hypertonia, no tone in a muscle, flaccid paralysis, you will see diminish or a loss of deep tendon reflexes. Okay, and now I would like to give you, show you the one example of deep tendon reflex. I'm going to show you the knee reflex, that is the knee jerk deep tendon reflex. To elicit knee jerk, you need this hammer. Okay, now if you want to elicit the knee jerk, just keep the knee in a 20 to 25 degree of flexion and slightly external rotation. Ask the patient to give all the weight of put all the weight of his limb on my hand. Now, with the broad end of hammer, just tap over the patella tendon. In normal person, whenever you tap on the patella tendon, you will get an extension. That is the normal extension of a knee. Okay, so first we'll see the normal response. Can you see slight extension of the knee? So this is the normal response of the knee jerk. Now, in case of UMN type of lesion, you will get the exaggerated knee reflex. That we'll see whenever you tap over the patella tendon. Yes, so this is the exaggerated of knee. Again, I am going to show you. So this is the exaggerated knee reflex that you find in UMN type of lesion. And in LMN type of lesion, you will see diminish or a loss of deep tendon reflex. So in LMN type of lesion, whenever I tap, I am not getting any response. Can you see? So this is the loss of reflex. So this is all about the deep tendon reflex in UMN and LMN. Now the next point is clonus. Clonus is the pathological reflex, and clonus you will find due to the spasticity. Okay, so clonus is present in UMN type of lesion and clonus is absent in LMN type of lesion. Now what is clonus? There are two types of clonus, ankle and patella. I am going to show you how to elicit clonus in UMN type of lesion. Okay, keep the patient hip in 90 degree flexion and 90 degree of knee flexion and just hold the patient limb like this. Okay, now in a normal person, when you tap over the forefoot, okay, you will not get any response. So this is the normal response. But due to excessive spasticity, you will get this pathological reflex. So suppose assume that this patient is having UMN type of lesion, and due to excessive spasticity, whenever you tap over the forefoot, you will get this type of oscillation, more than two oscillation. So whenever you find this type of oscillation after tapping it, so that is called as clonus. Again, this spasticity is not present in element type of lesion. So, clonus is not present in element type of lesion. And the last point is fasciculation. Fasciculation is a muscle twitch. So, the fasciculation is absent in UMN lesion. Why? Because UMN is a spasticity. And spasticity means constant contraction of the muscle. So, at that point, you will not find any fasciculation. And the fasciculation is present in element type of lesion. Because there is a flaccid type of paralysis, muscle does not have any tone. And the wasting is always there. So, you see the muscle twitch in element type of lesion. So, this is all about the difference between UMN element. In UMN hypertonia, element hypotonia. In UMN, you will see spastic paralysis. In element, you will see flaccid paralysis. Atrophy in UMN, disuse atrophy. In element, atrophy due to denervation. Superficial reflex lost in both the cases of UMN and element. Babin skin sign is positive in UMN, but it is the plantar reflex absent in element. The deep tendon reflexes are exaggerated in UMN, diminished and lost in element type of lesion. Clonus is present in UMN, whereas it is absent in element lesion. Fasciculation is absent in UMN type of lesion and it is present in element type of lesion. Now, I would like to give you some example of UMN and element type of lesion. UMN, stroke. Stroke is the disruption of the blood supply to cerebral cortex. So, it will directly cause the damage to corticospinal tract. So, it gives the symptoms of UMN type of lesion. Second is multiple sclerosis. Multiple sclerosis is the demyelination of a white matter of a brain and the spinal cord. And all of you know the white matter consists of the axon of the tract. So, it affects the tract and this tract gives, the affection of this tract gives you the UMN type of lesion. Okay. Third is motor neuron disease. Okay, in motor neuron disease, you will find both types of symptoms, UMN as well as element. There is a degeneration of the upper motor neuron fiber. So, you find the UMN type of lesion. Then the spinal cord injury. Now, spinal cord injury, suppose there is gunshot at the level of C7. The bullet stuck at the C7 segment of the spinal cord. So, at the same level, C7, it affects, it damages the anterior horn cell, alpha motor neuron and gamma motor neuron. So, all of you know the damage to alpha motor neuron cause the element type of symptom. But that C7 level will be totally affected. And you know the corticospinal tract is situated in lateral white column. Okay? So, corticospinal tract will also damage at that level. So, there is the loss of connection of corticospinal tract from the C7 level. Or above the C7 level and the lower part of C7 level. So, at the level, you will find element type of lesion. And below the level, you will find UMN type of lesion. Because there is loss of connection of corticospinal tract from above the C7 level and the below the C7 level. And now the element type of, I would like to give you some example of element type of lesion, polio. Okay, poliovirus attacks the anterior horn cell. So, it will give all the element type of symptoms. Second is GBS, Guillain-Barré syndrome. Guillain-Barré syndrome is a polyneuropathy. It affects the myelination of the nerve fiber. Okay, it affects the myelination of spinal nerve. Okay, so that gives the element type of symptom. Then foot drop, the local nerve injury to common peroneal. Okay, that will give you foot drop and this is element type of lesion. Then brachial plexus injury, that is also element type of lesion. Okay, any lumbar radiculopathy due to disc prolapse, the nerve will be compressed. So it gives the all the element type of lesion. So friends, this is all about the UMN and the element type of lesion. Hope you understood my this lecture. If you have not understood, you can write your doubt on the comment section. And the second thing, I have put all my links, lecture links below. You can click on it and check it. Thank you very much.